Okay, what are we doing today? We're going to clean the battery terminals. Most people use a wide brush. Whoop. Can you see? Yep. But I got a tool. Than by hand. So, I'll pick this up at Harbor Freight. It's called the Drill Master. It's the generic version of the Dremel. See? See? All right. Best to do this one because you can see it. Why brush it? Now we're gonna do this one. Let's spray the rag. See? Awesomely orange. A little clean. You don't have to, but it's all a bunch of, keeps it cool. This is a 6 month free replacement when not in. Recharge monthly when not in use. Alright. So that's pretty much using that tool. This is a battery box. I'll show you that after when I'm searching batteries. But for now, I got. We'll clean the top. Can you see? Make it so you can see. Yeah. All nice and clean. Blah blah blah. All right, gotta go. Okay, I'll show you. There's a lot of these the nuts and bolts I got from the truck that I shipped the other day, yesterday. But I can't seem to throw those nuts and bolts away. Fixing a tractor or a snowblower that you need one. Well, I found these pretty cool. Yeah, I gotta get my dad's magnet and just so I can beat the dirt out of it. I hope I have more because I gave the others with the other battery. No, thank you. Nope, that's not one. No, it's looking for these. See these? They got little teeth on them. They got little teeth on them. See? Little teeth. Watch. You take this. And we are going to go. Yeah, we'll go this way. Let's see, it's got a screwdriver head. Huh. And this one's different, so it's not going to really matter. And some batteries. I want to use the same size bolt. So what I do is take my wrench. Nope, it's not. 3/8. Probably like a 7/16. Take a wrench, okay? We find what? Is this the same size? No. What about this? Yeah. Looking for is a 3/8 nut, and I can't tell the difference. So I take my wrench and pry them. Oh, too big. But we can always do this too. Most people don't do when they're building something. They use new bolts, but when they're trying to find bolts like this to fit the battery tray, the battery protractor. Okay, we're going to do this. Take our bolt. See? Our bolt here. a wire brush. I wouldn't use sandpaper, a wire brush. You're actually just gonna clean it. What I'm doing. Clean it just enough. So, oops, I put a spot. Okay. Find a nut that fits it. Yeah, I know I'm a nut, but I don't fit it. Let me make sure we have the right size wrench. So we put it, through. Always make sure the head does not go through. Take our 3/8. You see? Now we find another 3/8. Okay. Take our wire brush. See? Get a wire brush on the end. What we're doing is we're cleaning out the groove. And this has got such a low RPM, it doesn't even... It won't hurt it. That's why I'll use this over a bench one, even though I don't have one. If I did, I still wouldn't need it. To clean the threads. So now, I take this. Okay. Put it on this side. Okay, we take our two wrenches, our 3/8. Okay. And we also go in here. To grab an adjustable. Yeah, well, it's not raining. Okay. things is. Just to keep the battery clean. What you gotta do though is hold the wire closest to the battery so when you snap the cover back on. This isn't gonna, everybody's like, oh, you can sell your track. You should sell your track. So you can get a lot of money right now. But, okay, now, gotta get. This piece. I pulled the bonehead and moved. Yes, I know. See, once the cover's on. Thank you. pawn. That wasn't on there. That was on the other tractor. So that's done. Okay. Now the other thing.